Joining us this morning on McLean's TV, the one and only Ronnie McFall, a legend in his own hairstyle, as he would tell you himself, of the Irish League. Ronnie, it's great to have you back, and a difficult enough league for Portadown so far.
Yeah, it's been an indifferent season for us, Aidan. We've obviously, you know, didn't recruit in the summer, which was difficult for us. And in this season so far, we've picked up a lot of injuries, a lot of key players out, and we've never really had a settled side from day one. And as I said, it's been a disappointing season so far.
Of course, you're into the second half now, and you'll hope for a change. And into that second half, you've lost Darren Murray away to Cliftonville, but you've got Philip Laurie in. That's a bit of a coup.
Yeah, well, I tried to sign him, Adrian, when he left Linfield, went to Derry City, but he wanted to give full-time football a go at that stage, so he did. And funny enough, just thinking about it coming down in the QR, I mean, his uncle's Jerry Mullen, played for Glentoran. John D. Nelson, ex-Glentoran chairman, we went over and signed him from Everton at that stage. So, as I said, there's that sort of connection going back, but he's certainly a quality player, very athletic, versatile. One of those box-to-box players can get you goals from midfield, and I've no doubt he'll be a big asset this and then the rest of the season.
He's based in London, he'll fly in for matches, and how will you keep tabs on his training, or will you know yourself very quickly if this lad's going to pull the wool over your eyes?
Well, he's one of those guys, Aidan, that is naturally fit, very athletic, and as I said, he'll be training with a non-league club over in England, and I've no doubt he'll be a big asset to us.
You talk about a big asset, so look at the Twitter feed from a lot of Portadown fans, and obviously Portadown Football Club. The fans certainly appreciate this signing. I think they believe that this is a very, very special signing for Portadown.
Well, it's very difficult, Aidan, in January to get the quality that he brings. I mean, as I said, it's not the best time really to be looking to bring players in. And as I said, we're just fortunate that we've got a player of his quality.
Do you think the connection with his uncle, you know, Jerry Mullen, do you think that helped whenever you made the phone call initially, out of the blue, basically, just to talk to him?
Yeah, it certainly didn't do any harm. You know, Jerry Mullen was, you know, a really good lad and really outstanding Irish League player. He played for Northern Ireland as well, so as I said, there was that connection.
Whenever you take a look at Portadown, you're fairly well down the league. The chances of winning the league title now are probably gone, Ronnie. Would that be a fair thing to say?
Yeah, I think that's a fair comment, Aidan, no question about that. Our objective now, obviously, is to try and get into the top six and going on to win the Irish Cup. I mean, with the change in the format of qualification for Europe now, you know, the team that finishes seventh even has a chance of getting into Europe. So, obviously, that's the two main objectives for us from now to the end of the season.
And Europe equals finance. Very important, isn't it, at this level?
Yeah, well, we suffered big style, Aidan, after the cup final last year, where we felt we were really hard done by with the officials. And from financially, that was a big blow to the club. So hopefully we can make up for it this year.
Interesting, you come in here into McLean's, the home of the Glentoran sponsors, and you still, one thing about you, you haven't forgotten last season's cup final.
Well, I think anybody, Aidan, that was involved in it, or our supporters, and the decisions that went against us were really hard to take. I mean, you can accept and you hold your hands up with a better side in the day and they tank you 4-5. That's not a problem. But with the, as I said, with the whole issues of the cup final and the venue and everything else, it left a sour taste in everyone's mouth.
You enjoy the cup and you've got a home draw against Coleraine, which won't be hard to motivate the players. I almost think, you know, when you look to a cup, and I'm sure you'll agree, once you get a home draw, it's a real bonus. If you get a Premier League team, it means it's not going to be hard to get the players to lift themselves for this.
No, well, Coleraine's a good side, Aidan, and they've had a good start to the season so far. I mean, they've beat us twice this year, and in cup competitions, I just believe the best you can hope for is home advantage, and we're fortunate that we've got that.
Ronnie, what's the mood in a dressing room when a player of the likes of Murray decides to leave because he wants to leave? And one thing about you in Portadown, when a player wants to go, you rarely try to hold on to them. You let them go, you know, as all managers do. What's the mood whenever somebody decides to go, but then it's balanced whenever you pull in somebody like Laurie?
Well, the situation with Darren Murray was he wanted to go to Cliftonville, and we had inquiries from Linfield, Glentoran, Cliftonville and Derry City. But he had his heart set in going to Cliftonville. During when it all broke in the close season, it was coming near the end of the of the transfer window, so I had basically no time to get anyone in. So it was a question then that I sat down with him, had a chat with him and whatever, and he agreed he would stay then, right? So come January again this month, the whole thing reared its head again. So I think it was better for everyone that he went. Certainly an outstanding player in my mind, only 24 years of age. His best years are still ahead of him, and he's a good lad. And we certainly wish him well. And as I said, with him going, we certainly needed a lift. And Philip Lowry hopefully give us that lift.
And does that give a lift in, you know, with the lads, you know, with the long-standing players in Portadown, you know, some of your more experienced lads, would they see that as a real statement of intent by Portadown?
Yeah, I think that's what happens in all sports, Aidan. You know, when new players come in, it gives everybody a lift. It refocuses their mind that you know, we've got to perform here. And I've no doubt that he'll do really well for us.
Right, Ronnie, you've been there at Shamrock Park, you've been involved in the game for I don't know how many years now, you know, there's that many accolades and records about you, and then they're now talking in Portadown that you're going to be part of the whole scheme to look for a new manager. Spell it out to me, does that mean that's the end of you, or is it the end of you until they get a new manager, or if they don't get the proper manager, are you still going to be in situ? What is the situation with the Garda, Ronnie, this season?
Well, the situation, Adrian, is my contract's up at the end of the season. So what happens after that, we'll just wait and see. But I certainly intend to still be involved in football.
So Mr. McMahon could play a part, and the Portadown board could play a part come at the end of this season. You know, I know you don't want to be talking about it, but there would be an opportunity if they so decided that you could actually stay on as Portadown manager.
Well, that has never been discussed, and you know, as I said, I mean, my contract's up at the end of the season, so I mean, I'll just keep my options open and see what materialises from there.
So what you're saying to me, and I'm not trying to draw too much, well, I probably am trying to draw a lot out of you too as well, that if you don't stay as Portadown boss, the chances are you could go conceivably to another club because you still have the love of football.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. No doubt about that. Football's in my blood. It's all I've ever done and wanted to do, you know, so I'll certainly just not turn my back on the game, that's for sure.
What would you do on a Saturday, Ronnie, if you didn't have football?
Well, I wouldn't go shopping, that's for sure.
But at the same time, she goes to the football too, doesn't she?
Yeah, she goes to football too. She never misses, you know.
Uh-huh. It's been a great career for you, hasn't it?
Yeah, I've enjoyed it, Aidan, you know. I mean, you know, you don't stay in some of the length of time that I have if you don't get a thrill and enjoyment out of it, you know. I mean, there's nothing beats 3 points on a Saturday night. And as I said, I'll still be involved in some capacity.
Well, look... I just was thinking there, and I will put you on the spot a wee bit, could you give me an idea of maybe your top 5 or 6 players over that glittering career that you've had, the players that have stood out for you, maybe even, not even Portadown players, but just players that you have come along in the Irish League? Would you have an idea of the top 5, 6, even top 3, whatever you want?
Well, when I started off as a young lad, Aidan, I made my first team debut for Portadown against Linfield, and that was in the era of Tommy Dixon, Wilbur Cush, Billy Ferguson, those sort of guys, the likes of Billy Humphreys at Orange, you know, outstanding players through all generations. And I think it's difficult to turn around and you know, pick 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 over the period of time that that I've been involved in the game. No question about that. Billy Johnson at Glenavon. Albert Campbell at Crusaders, whatever, you know, all outstanding Irish League players going back in that era.
But Ronnie, I know it's difficult when you look at different eras, but you mentioned a few of the all-time greats they got, but there's been so many other good players in Irish League football, a much maligned Irish League football, and probably not deserving of the abuse and criticism they've got over the years.
Yeah, I think, Adrian, it's a good product. I think it's undervalued here. I don't think people appreciate the quality sometimes what is in Irish football, Irish League football, and the players that's in it. You know, in recent years, you know, the likes of Glenn Ferguson, Linfield, Glenn Dunlop of Crusaders, Jim Cleary, Glenn Thorne, Sid Burrows, Crusaders and whatever, and you know, McBride and those boys of Glenavon, all outstanding Irish League players. You know, if you look at the ones that we have had, obviously you always refer back to Cian Fraser sort of players, but I mean, and as well as those guys, you had the likes of Alfie Stewart, Brian Strain and Major and them boys too, and Greg Davison, all outstanding Irish League players.
People say that the modern game has lost a lot of personalities and a lot of characters. I wouldn't necessarily agree with that. There's still some great characters playing Irish League football, isn't there? And yeah, you have a few at your own club as well.
Yeah, there's a outstanding player still playing in the game here, 18 at the minute. You know, I think one of the things that's lacking here badly is training facilities, basically for all clubs. I know at Shamrock Park, that's the one thing that we really, really, really need is decent training facilities, which we haven't got. And as I said, basically all clubs have players coming through, and players that have been there in recent years would have been outstanding players, you know.
We're in the European Championships, qualified under Michael O'Neill, which is a great boost to everybody and a great boost to football. But will that boost to football permeate down to the Irish Premiership and to all the clubs, do you feel? Like, will there be any financial benefit from us qualifying for the Euro even?
Well, I think, Aidan, obviously the IFA get a lot of money out of qualifying for the Euros and whatever, and I think it's in their hands then to filter some of that money down to local football. Because if you look at the Northern Ireland squad at the minute, a lot of those players have come out of Irish League football. The likes of McCauley and Dallas and those lads have all played Irish League football, Liam Boyce or whatever, right? So I think it's beneficial to the IRCFA and the Irish League football on a whole that some of that money would filter down to the local football.
Ronnie, if you could change anything in football, what would be the big change you would make? A man of your calibre, a man of your standing, you've been involved in the game from the very start, the whole way, player, manager, official, the whole lot. What's the one thing you would change? Now be careful, there's a family show.
better not mention referees.
No. We'll exclude the referees.
Better leave them out. That's a hard question. I think Aidan, they could bring in, they're bringing in goal line technology now, and I think they could bring in, you know, there's talk of the way they're doing rugby and all sports, where they can freeze it and then go back in 30 seconds or whatever to see if the referee's decision's right or wrong. I think the likes of that will come in eventually. I think the timing of matches, knowing the rugby, it's not the referee that looks after the time, it's technicians up in the boxes look after. So I think the likes of those things can come in, which would benefit it greatly too, because you get a lot of, you know, controversy. You're into 4 minutes, 5 minutes injury time or whatever, and then it drags on, and sometimes it's goal scored or whatever, which causes a lot of controversy.
I'm going to say that now in rugby, the TMO, the television match official, sometimes you look at referees now in rugby and they never want to make a decision. They refer all the time. I presume that'd have to be almost like a... You could have it a wee bit like tennis, where a manager's allowed 2 calls in each half, yeah, and say, I would like that looked. I would like that referred upstairs to the television.
Yeah. Well, I think even with the modern technology that they have now, it's only a matter of time to the likes of that has to come into it, because, I mean, especially in the, you know, like say Premier League and at the very highest level, there's that much money at stake that basically they have to cut out all the errors that's been made.
So it means then that the whole idea of the game, playing the game, and human error, you're trying to say there shouldn't be. There's too much at stake.
Exactly. Too much at stake. I mean, you know, these Premiership clubs are playing for, you know, tens of millions of pounds. And as I said, there's a lot at stake for human error to have a big impact on that.
And never mind tens of millions of pounds. There's a lot of stake when you're on the line in Shamrock Park, no matter who you're playing.
That's right.
I've listened to the fans. I know what it's like, yeah, too, you know. But Ronnie, listen, you've been you've graced the game for a long, long time. And the good news is for the fans, everybody involved in sport, should it be Portadown or not, that come this summer, God's willing, you're still going to be heavily involved in football in some capacity.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.